According to reports from Reuters and the Wall Street Journal, Qualcomm, known for powering the world's top smartphones, is interested in buying Intel. You probably know Intel as the ones who made Intel Core or Pentiums. They're probably the ones powering your computer right now. They were once the biggest chipmaker in the world, so how have we reached a point where Qualcomm might buy out Intel? And what does that mean for high-end chips? For several years, despite heavy investments and new leadership, Intel has been struggling. They've fallen behind TSMC, the world's largest chip factory, which makes advanced chips for companies like NVIDIA, AMD, and even Qualcomm. Delays in building factories, losing government contracts, and reliability issues have hurt Intel's reputation and stock price, with it down 40% this year. Earlier this summer, we discussed Qualcomm's ambitions in the laptop markets. They had lower than expected sales for the Snapdragon X laptops that we talked about, and this might be the reason that made them interested in acquiring Intel's PC division. However, a merger between Qualcomm and Intel seems highly unlikely. Qualcomm would need over $50 billion, and global regulators would need to all approve the deal. Given the current climate and antitrust lawsuits being filed against big tech companies, that seems improbable to say the least. This potential merger highlights the priorities of both Intel and Qualcomm. While companies like TSMC and NVIDIA are very profitable, investors are skeptical about Intel's current strategy. There are lots of other arguments against the merger, but first and foremost is that reports of Intel's death have been greatly exaggerated. When CEO Pat Gelsinger took over in 2021, he anticipated tough times and set long-term goals for 2030. Intel still has one of the strongest R&D teams in the world and can still catch up. But if they keep missing out on contracts and losing stock value, other companies might step in and eat their lunch. Competitors like TSMC could continue to dominate the high-end chip market. In the processor market, companies like AMD, Qualcomm, Amazon, MediaTek, or even Huawei could gain even more ground than they have now. The stakes are high for all chip makers at the moment, especially with growing investment from the AI industry. And I think that's all that there is to say about the Qualcomm-Intel merger. It's unlikely to happen, but it still tells us something interesting about the industry. And if you want more interesting reports about technology, you can make sure you're subscribed to TechAsia and leave us a comment to let us know what you want us to talk about or what you think about this potential merger deal. Until next time, I guess you'll just have to take care.